670 WOCA. Ocala.
Minutes after 9 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. You know, we had a busy weekend, and I was thinking, oh boy, I don't know if I want to go back. It's Monday. And then I remembered, oh, Bern comes in today.
Yeah.
I always enjoy when Bern comes in. Bern Pareso is here. And good morning, Bern. How you doing?
I am doing really great. How are you?
Good, good. I do like when you're here.
Can you hear me if I just do this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my job. My job is to make sure you're heard.
I wasn't sure if I really have to.
I know a lot of people do that. You don't have to bend forward, no.
Okay, good.
Those are specially designed microphones.
Stretch my back.
Right, right.
That's with your velvet outfit.
It is, yeah.
You look beautiful as always.
Oh, thank you.
And we missed you. You said you went to the Strawberry Festival.
I did. You wouldn't believe this. I was actually washing, you know, my car, and then I got a call from a friend of mine, and she said, let's go. There's a strawberry festival out there. And I said, yeah, I got to have strawberries. So anyway, I went, and I had a lot of fun.
Oh, good, good.
I had strawberry shortcake, then corn on the cob, and popcorn.
Oh, wonderful.
After 2 hours, I left.
Oh, man. I wish we bumped into you. Then you would have been on our video. We made a video of the event.
I was actually looking for you.
Well, we were there. But if you were there in the middle of the day, that's when we were not there, because we took a break and came back here because we had to do something here.
And, you know, I was surprised. It was so crowded.
It was hugely crowded, right?
Yeah. Over 20,000 people.
So.
Well, anyway, good morning to all our listeners, our doctors, and also Roger Bitogo in the Philippines. He is listening with Tessie Silva.
Oh.
I got a call last night that they will be watching me.
Oh.
So this is Ian. Aurora Zamboanga del Sur, Mindanao, Philippines.
Oh, man.
So, good evening to you. It's probably 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. And can you say hi to them in Philippine language? What is the Philippine language? What do you call it?
It should be Filipino.
Filipino.
But I speak a dialect, which is another...
Well, I'll understand it either way.
The island. Magandang gabi. It's good evening. To all of you.
Magandang gabi?
Correct, yeah.
Oh, I think I can handle that language.
Magandang gabi. It's very similar to Spanish. So,
that
Robin
didn't sound
has that background.
Spanish.
Like, magandang gabi.
You have that background.
So, anyway, I am so excited this morning because this month of March is called Colorectal Cancer Month.
You go from Magandang Gabi.
Magandang Gabi,
to
that's
colorectal
correct.
Cancer.
So you can be a Filipino. So anyway,
I'm not sure what I understand.
Magandang Gabi is good evening.
Okay.
I may have said it correctly. I may have not said it correctly because, you know, I speak Cebuano.
Oh,
another dialect.
Cebuano.
But there's quite a few Filipinos here in Ocala. Good morning to you in Colorectal Cancer Month. And how
what
do
a month.
We? It is a month, yeah, correct. You know, the breast cancer, they also have October, I believe.
Yes.
I could be wrong. Yeah, isn't that nice?
It's
so
wonderful.
This is a reminder that we need to take care of our, you know, health and get colon screening. So maybe in the next 5 minutes, let me just go over a little bit. And this is like my fourth month talking about colonoscopy.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it
about
is.
About how important
yes,
it is. So
yes.
Just to give you a little bit of an overview, since this is colorectal month and I have probably 3 weeks discussing about the importance of colon screening. So again, what is colonoscopy? Colonoscopy is a common medical test that is frequently done to screen for cancer of the rectum and colon. Again, colon is the large intestine. During a colonoscopy, your doctor will very carefully insert a thin, flexible tube with a lighted fiber optic camera.
A camera,
this is called, yeah. Colonoscope.
News at 6.
You're playing with your imagination there. And this is inserted in your rectum.
I figured,
all right?
Yeah.
In colon. So the colonoscope sends pictures, so mm-hmm. you can picture it, into the colonoscope, I'm sorry, sends pictures of the inside of your colon uh-huh. to a video screen so your doctor can check for polyps, abnormal growths, or colon cancer.
That's really a good idea.
I know what's, yeah,
oh,
I know
sure
what's
it is.
Happening. That's why I can't.
Oh, you need your glasses.
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
How would I do this?
You just put them on.
wait. You have to take your headphones off first, then put your glasses on, then put your headphones back on again. Okay. That works for
okay.
me.
Oh,
you look cute in glasses.
Oh, thank you.
What you so still got the you still got the price tag on them?
It's brand new.
I do. Yeah. I just picked it up.
There it is.
I should have known. I see one out there.
It's on it.
Well, it is. I just knit.
A new fashion.
All right, it is. So anyway, when you are 50, this is what happens.
That's right.
Okay, so what happens during a colonoscopy? When you arrive at your doctor's office for your colonoscopy, you will have an IV placed in a vein in your hand or arm so you can be given medicines and fluids. Right before the test is to begin, your doctor will give you a mild sedative to help make you as comfortable as possible.
Good.
I know.
Do we need to be comfortable for this?
Well, it's just to let you know that they wouldn't just poke you anywhere.
Okay.
So as you lie on your side or back, your doctor will slowly and gently put the colonoscope
right, inside.
Into where?
I know.
That's right. That's where it goes.
And up through your colon. So you may, however, feel some pressure, bloating, or cramping during the test. What happens after the colonoscopy? And this is after.
You say, thank God. That's what happens. It's all done.
After your test, you will have to rest for a while until the effects of the medicine wear off. While you are resting, your doctor will talk to you about the results of your test and whether any polyps were removed. If a biopsy was performed, you can expect to get the results in a few days. So do not plan to drive. You must have someone with you. Community, remember, you cannot drive to get this procedure. However, there should be a guidelines, you know, during your consult, so you do not have to worry about it. Ask a friend to drive you because you cannot drive after the colonoscopy because of sedation. So anyway, colorectal month is March. Get your screening today. Do not wait. If you have symptoms or no symptoms.
No symptoms or symptoms.
That is correct.
What is it, a once a year thing?
Colonoscopy is done once every 10 months, provided.
Every 10 months?
No, I'm sorry. Wrong one. 10 years.
10 years?
Oh, okay.
10 years.
Okay.
If you are 50 years old and older, however, if you have a family.
Have you had it? Have you had it done?
I am going to get it done.
Do you want me to make a video?
we can do that.
I want you to take a picture.
This will be great. This will be viral. We'll do that.
We all have to do this. You know, there has been a lot of findings about colon cancer. So the earlier, the better.
Look at the size of that ring you're wearing. Did I ever comment on that before?
It's beautiful.
The pearl, is that a pearl?
It's absolutely gorgeous.
The ring?
It is outstanding.
You're so observant.
Well, how could I miss that? That looks like the Epcot ball.
Well, hold for a second. Hers a magic.
See, oh, you got one on your neck.
Yeah. You've seen this before.
I have.
But
yeah,
I love it.
I love it.
Pearl. Thank you. Anyway, community, my program wouldn't be alive if not because of my sponsor, Seven Hill Gastroenterology, Dr. Vishnu Reddy. How are you there, doctor? Central Florida Endoscopy and Endoscopy. It's Doug Monteith. Thank you, Doug, and Candy Paquette. Good morning to all the Seven Hill staff. Good morning to Dr. Ann Patel, Dr. Raj Patel, Dr. Asad Kumar. It is actually 1 hour. I look at you.
I know, it's 1 hour. Oh, that clock is wrong. Yeah, I forgot. No wonder you're looking at it funny.
I went to church yesterday and I was late.
Oh, were you? Do they change the clocks in the Philippines?
No, actually, no? 12 hours difference.
So you never have a daylight savings time thing? No.
We don't. Mm-mm. But anyway, thank you again so much. This is a beautiful Monday. Guess what? Our time is up. This is fun. This is a good start. And I know that we'll finish.
This is why I would say, oh, it's Monday. Bern will be in. I'll enjoy Monday.
But anyway, thank you so much. I'm Bern Parezo.
Yes, you are.
With our friends here at WOCA, Larry and Robin. I will be back next Monday the same time. So stay tuned. And thank you again so much for listening.
If you're watching in the Philippines, let me show what Robin looks like. Hold on.
No,
they're watching.
No, I can't hold a candle to Bern.
Well, yeah, but they want to see what you look like. There you are. Yes, that's Robin.
That's Robin.
There you go.
Can you just
talk
about
put
yourself?
It on me. Put it on
and
me.
And this is Larry.
There I am. That's me.
Yeah, very nice, you know, guys to work with. So one of these days you got to come to Ocala, Florida, here at the Paddock Mall. And actually, there is something going on Saturday here.
What is it?
Oh.
CD, what is that? CDC? There's, I know, because
Childhood Development Council is happening
my
Saturday.
Son
that's right.
Is,
oh, this coming Saturday. Oh,
that's
wow.
That's right.
Yeah. But anyway, I will be back. Thank you again so much, and see you next week.
Did you buy any strawberries at the festival?
Yes, I did.
Tonight, today's strawberry day? You're going to eat strawberries?
Yeah, I did. I had a box.
No, but today, are you going to eat some today?
Oh, yeah.
See, Robin brought in a whole bunch of them for the radio station.
Yep.
Yeah,
it's in the refrigerator.
I should have bought you some.
Do you want you want some strawberry shortcake?
Oh, yes.
Well, come.
Did you really?
Robin has some.
Do you really?
Yeah, would you like some before you go home?
You want some before you leave?
I will.
Okay.
Okay,
do you
I'll
really?
Go prepare.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well,
yeah.
Thank you so much.
Prepare
Thank you, Bern.
You're welcome.
We'll be right back. This is WOCA.
Do you know?
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. Times of clouds and sun today. There can be a brief shower or two around, mainly during the afternoon hours over the entire